And in that first year that you took the pub, what changes did you make? What did you have to do?
Well, we refurbed it, obviously. We had to build all new seating, new carpeting and stuff like that, you know. And in the process of which, we found some old fag packets under the bar. And some of them hadn't been made since whenever, year dot. So I stuck them up on the wall, and then customers started saying, oh, I've got an old fag pack I found in my loft or whatever. And they're all up there now. They're still there. Loads and loads of old fag packets. That one has not been made since 1924.
Brilliant.
So, you know, that's 100 years old, that fag packet. So there's all sorts of... But there is history in everything in here. There's nothing that's on the walls or whatever that doesn't have a story to it.
What are the plaques behind the bar?
That's simply that my eldest boy was in the Royal Navy. So he came in one day with a plaque for the ship that he was on at the time. We stuck it up on the wall. And then various customers said, oh, I was with such a thing, or I was with that. Can I stick mine up as well? Because it's in the garage. The wife doesn't want it on the living room, or whatever it was. So people started almost being competitive with it. Well, if theirs is up, I want mine up as well. So we've got 1, 2 and 3 parachute regiment, Blues and Royals, various Royal Navy ships, Hong Kong police up there, SAS 22, SAS 23, New Scotland Yard, and South Yorkshire Police, Regional Crime Squad. There's one up here which you can't quite see from the old soccer, the old Serious Organised Crime Squad up there. Well, so all customers that down the years have been in and said, oh, we'd like to pop that up there. So for quite a long time, there's a lovely fella called Mike James, who was a now retired school teacher, but also an extremely gifted artist. And for many years, he used to create a Fagan's Christmas card. And we used to have a couple of hundred of these, which we gave to the customers. And the original that he created, we would keep. And we've quite a few of these around the walls. One or two have disappeared for one reason or another, but there are lots of them. This one is 1992. And I think it's my favourite because Mike James, not only a gifted artist, but a very witty man. And this is a picture of, and it's tiny, but this is Fagan's. And the star is above Fagan's. And there are three little figures just walking in the front door. So it's very Christmassy. But of course, Mike James, being a very clever and witty man, has created a subliminal message. Fagan's, where the wise men drink. Okay, this is a picture of the original Cole's Corner. If you're not quite sure where you're looking, that's High Street. That's Boots, which is still there. That building has been used for a variety of things, but it's still there as it is. But that was what Cole's Corner was. And the convention was in Sheffield, again, no mobile phones or anything like that, that a boy would meet a girl, girl would meet a boy, whatever, and then say, right, I'll see you Saturday, 6:30, Cole's Corner. That was the great meeting place, which is why Richard Hawley, of course, called his album Cole's Corner. And the song Cole's Corner is about that, about young boys and girls meeting up and, you know, a bit some sadness in there as well, a bit of tristesse as well. But one of the guys who worked at West Bar, a detective sergeant he was then, and he came and he said, you know this album that Richard Hawley's brought out, Cole's Corner? I said, yeah. He said, my gaffer has got a picture of Cole's Corner on the wall behind his desk, he said, and I've looked through the archives of Sheffield sort of paint photos and things, it's not there. I think it's a one-off because there's a policeman on point duty. And as a child, of course, I actually remember seeing that. I remember Cole Brothers vividly because when I was 5, I got my elbow caught in the revolving brass door there. You know, it was like sort of Harrods, you know, posh. And I remember screaming with my elbow caught there. And there was a policeman on point duty. So that's why it was there. So he said, if I were to borrow it, he said, do you think you could get some copies of it. I said, well, I know my mate across the road as a printer, I'm sure he'd do that. And he said, do you think you could get Richard Hawley to sign them? Because Richard's albums, Cole's Corner, had just come out. And I said, I'm sure Richard agreed to that. So one wet evening, about a week later, the door opens and in came John with this, the original of this, still in the frame with the screws hanging out. And there sitting in the bar was his boss, the detective superintendent. And he said, all right, John. He says, all right, Gaffer. And then walked upstairs with this thing. And then left. His, night, Gaffer. Night. So fair play to him. His boss, Paul, a lovely, lovely man. He sat there for half an hour before he said anything. He said, come on then, let's be knowing. I said, you're going to get it back. We're not nicking it. So we're going to copy it, get Richard Hawley to sign it, and your original will be back on the wall. He said, how many copies? I said, 10. He said, 11. I said, done. So, and that's one of 11. There are 11 copies of that signed by Richard, and that's the original Cole's Corner. But, of course, with a tail. It's Fagan, so there's always a tail.
Do you know, I've never seen anybody play darts in here.
That's because there's no dartboard.
Is there not actual in there?
It fell out of a student's head 6 years ago. We never replaced it.
Oh, I see.
The board, that is, not the head.
Yeah.